Good morning, children. Praise the Lord. We meet again today. Stay happy and healthy in this new day. Before we start our today's activities, let's listen to God's word this morning. Taken from the book, Straight Ahead, written by Adlai Aiste, PhD. And this morning, we will learn from the title, Inspiration Was the Word. Before we proceed, shall we start with a prayer? Thank you, Lord, for the new day. Now we are ready to listen to your words. May your Holy Spirit be within us to lead us and bless us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our memory verse for today is from Timothy chapter 6, verse 12. It says, Fight the good fight of the faith. Take hold of the eternal life to which you were called when you made your good confession in the presence of many witnesses. Children, George was a 14-year-old Hungarian boy. He was one of the thousands of displaced people from Central Europe after World War II. He had never lived in an English-speaking country, but he spoke English very well. The American news reporters in New York were amazed at his ability to handle the English language. One ship's news reporter asked him, How in the world did you learn such fluent English? George explained that he had taught himself with a dictionary, a book on basic English, and a few copies of the Reader's Digest that he had found in a Danish TV camp. He explained how he would write down every English word he didn't understand. Then he would look up these words. Soon he was reading whole sentences without looking up these words. He claimed that he read every word in every copy of the Reader's Digest. In fact, he is reported to have said, Reading the Digest makes me so excited. I want to do things. No matter how torn and soiled a Reader's Digest in the camp might be, everybody wanted to see it. It always amazed me that a little book could make the poor or pained people feel as we did. I guess it must have been because it means America. George thought how a hurricane had delayed their ship with its 500 passengers for 3 days. But he was so happy to reach the United States that he exclaimed, It would take more than a hurricane to dim my happiness at reaching America. His father, who was with him, spoke only in Hungarian to reporters, and George interpreted. Father said, The Reader's Digest is my... It is said that it was the first time that the boy failed to find the right English word. Then he and his father turned the pages of a little pocket dictionary. The father pointed to a word and George cried, That is father! Children, the word was inspiration. Let us juniors be sure that what we read brings us this priceless treasure, inspiration. This is the end of our morning worship. Children, there is a saying, books are windows to the world. Yes, by reading a book, it means that you are opening a window to the world. By reading a book, you can gain various knowledge that you don't know yet that will increase your insight. Children, George, the boy, has opened a window to his world through the books he's reading, and he's been inspired to do something. Children, then how about you? Are you also ready this morning to open a window to your world through a book that you will read? Pray to God that He will help you open a window to your world through the books you read and find inspiration to do good and right things for yourself and those around you. May the Lord Jesus bless and protect all of your children on this wonderful day. Amen.